I've held various positions with both local, regional, and the national offices. I've been very active in the Detroit local chapter where I currently reside, in various positions from business managers, chair of fundraiser, chair of the scholarship committee, and then a regional board member for the Midwest, and most recently the immediate past first vice president for the national organization, where I served as the chair over national committees as well as the chair of fundraising. So, and I think what I like to believe that I've effectively changed because of my involvement is, one, to have more collaboration among alumni and to reach the goals that I set. So my goal when I came into office as the first national vice president was to have a gala that would surpass anything that we've ever done, and to have it on a level that it could be something that would be continued every year for us. That was my goal when I came into office, because we'd never had it done. And I'm very grateful to say in 2012 we had our first successful gala with raising over $93,000 in revenue. So
awesome. So what specific character traits do you have that make you a good candidate for the first vice president?
The first, I think, would be integrity. Integrity. I think in anything that we do, there needs to be integrity in the process and integrity for the person. And integrity would be the first that I would say. And the second is a love for the university and for the Alumni Association. I love JSU. It's my alma mater. It's where I've had generations of my family to be members. My mother and my husband, who is Robert Norwood, is a JSU graduate. His mother is a JSU graduate. Our son came to JSU, and his great-grandmother is a JSU graduate. So there's a lot of legacy for the university, just with my family, but even more legacy when you think about what is to come. And that's really where I am. I want to make sure the university is here, not just for my grandchildren, but for generations to come. That's where my heart is.
Awesome. So how do you plan to support the mission of the association?
Well, the mission is to make sure that we get students here, that we bring students in, and that we continue to grow our legacy and our history. So I think there isn't one answer to that. I think there are many different things that we need to do in order for that to happen. And my first would be to make sure that we get alums not just enrolled or paying their dues, but get alums actively engaged. That's where the mission is. The mission is in the people. The people who are a part of this organization, the people who are great alums who serve us everywhere they go. We want them to have a voice, and we want them to be active with us all across the world, wherever they are.
Okay, and is there anything that I didn't cover that you'd like to add?
Well, I must say, again, I'm very pleased, very grateful, and very honored to have the opportunity to run for this office of first vice president of the national organization again, which is indeed an honor. And because of that, it's something that I see very, very early on. It's not something that I could do on my own. It takes a team. And I'm very grateful that I'm running and serving with the team, with Annette Johnson, who will serve as president, and Tarita Benson Davis as second vice president, because I think we need collective thinking, and we need to work strongly in every level of the organization to bring about the things that we want to happen. Enrollment, endowments for the national organization, which is what I'd like to see. $1 million endowment as a first vice president. I want us to have those type of funds at our access. So I'm grateful that there is a team of not only Johnson and Benson Davis, but most of all the team of our alums all across the world who care about JSU becoming actively involved. And that's what I want to do to make sure that happens.
Awesome.